this constellation. This might help. It's Orion. There's the belt. There's the sword. We're going to head for the sword. This video is made using the data from the Hipparchus satellite, which mapped the distances to the nearest 100,000 or so stars. And we're using astronomical photographs, many of them with Hubble Space Telescope. This is the Orion Nebula, this big cloud of gas lit up by the hot young stars that are forming in it. As we pass the Horsehead Nebula, we're now 1,500 light years from Earth. Here's another one of these stellar nurseries, the Rosette Nebula. Again, these bright young stars are lighting up a glowing gas cloud. But not all these glowing gas clouds are places where stars are born. This is a place where a star died. We saw the supernova explosion on Earth about 1,000 years ago. This is the Crab Nebula, and you can see the Crab pulsar pulsing there in the center. The debris from explosions like this creates a tremendous amount of dust, which blocks our view in the disk of the Milky Way. So we're going to rise up and out of the disk so that we can see the gorgeous panorama of a gigantic galaxy like our own. As our galaxy recedes into the distance with the large and small Magellanic Clouds and other satellite galaxies, everything we see now is a galaxy. Here's the other big galaxy in our local group, the Great Galaxy in Andromeda, and a smaller spiral galaxy, M33. As we pass through this glowing gas cloud in M33, we're now 2 million light years from home. Now we're heading for the Virgo cluster, but we're taking a scenic route past some of the prettiest nearby galaxies. Notice how the galaxies are not spread at random. There's a long filament of galaxies here. And we're going to ride down that filament as we approach the Virgo cluster. What we're in now is a group of galaxies called the Ursa Major Cluster. They're all spirals. But as we get closer to the Virgo Cluster, we're seeing more elliptical galaxies, big balls of stars without a disk. The center of the Virgo Cluster is this gigantic elliptical galaxy, M87, which has a black hole at its center that weighs more than 2 billion times the mass of our Sun, with this jet coming out of it. Well, that was a trip of about 60 million light years. But that was actually a very small trip compared to what we're going to do now. What we're going to do now is go as far as we can go with the deepest optical image that has yet been taken with the most advanced camera on Hubble Space Telescope. It's the ultra deep field, which was taken a couple of years ago by the Advanced Camera for Surveys. In order to put this in perspective, we're going to start again looking toward the familiar constellation Orion. There's Orion. There's Taurus the Bull. We're going to focus in on a little spot down here. We start with astronomical photographs from the ground, switch over to photographs taken with one of the older cameras on Space Telescope, and now switch to very deep images that were taken with the Advanced Camera for Surveys. And now, the ultra-deep field, the deepest image that we've yet taken. Along with many other astronomers, I've been puzzling over what this could be. Or this galaxy, or this oddly shaped thing, or this one, or that one. The very distant galaxies don't look like nearby galaxies. You don't see these regular spirals and elliptical galaxies. We can measure the distance of these galaxies and put them in the computer in three dimensions so that we can zoom into the picture. The galaxies that are disappearing off to the edge of the field are the nearby ones. All the light that we're looking at now has been traveling toward us for at least 4 billion years. Now about 8 billion years. Now about 10 billion years. Do you see any more of those big spiral or elliptical galaxies? They apparently have not had time to form yet. We're now back to the first 2 billion years. Now the first 1 billion years. If there were any more bright galaxies, Hubble Space Telescope would have seen them. Well, there's a different strategy that we can use to study the distribution of galaxies in the sky, and that's to map large regions of the sky. The biggest project, which is still ongoing, is the Sloan Digital Sky Survey. A telescope at Apache Point, New Mexico, is being used to map all the galaxies that we can see from that telescope out to a distance of about 2 billion light years, all the reasonably bright galaxies, and the very bright galaxies out to a distance of 6 billion light years, and the quasars, which are brighter still, out to a distance of 28 billion light years. Now, some of you may be surprised, since the universe itself is less than 14 billion years old. We'll come back to that. But let's first of all look at how these galaxies are distributed in the sky. So what we're going to do is visualize the Data Release 4, which includes over 500,000 galaxies and over 75,000 quasars. Here they all are. This takes a little while. So we're backing away now from the nearby part of the universe. We're out about 1 billion light years. Now about 2 billion light years. As these red objects come in, they represent the very luminous but distant galaxies, which are mapped out to a distance of 6 billion light years. You can already see some of the structures. You see these walls of galaxies with voids in between. There's a lot of galaxies here, but that's just because that's a region that's been mapped in great detail, because we can see it very clearly from Apache Point, New Mexico. In order to get a three-dimensional sense of this distribution of galaxies, let's rotate the image. You can see how the distribution of galaxies is very frothy. The galaxies form these great walls with voids, with hardly any galaxies in between. Now the quasars. And now we're seeing the Big Bang from the outside. This is the heat radiation of the Big Bang itself.